Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Patty Nowakowski.
Number two.
My name is Patty Nowakowski.
Number three.
My name is Patty Nowakowski.
Only one of these people is the real Patty Nowakowski and is the only one sworn to tell the truth. Now let's meet our panel. Actor and raconteur Orson Bean. Former Miss America Mary Ann Mobley. Star of the new feature film Popcorn, Tom Villard. And to tell the truth's very own, Kitty Carlisle. Here's the host of To Tell the Truth, Gordon Elliott.
Thank you and welcome. Good morning, panel. Feeling fit?
Oh, good morning. Yes, indeed.
You know, Orson, I was thinking years ago, didn't I hear you inventing something about an orgone bed, which was better for having sex in? Is that correct?
Good heavens, no. Where can I buy one of those?
No, wasn't there some kind of box you had?
I wrote a book called Me and the Orgone, which was about a guy who invented the orgone box, which cured everything from a lousy sex life to the common sniffles, it is alleged. The guy is no longer with us. What?
Did you sleep with it?
No, I didn't sleep in it. I sat in it once or twice and caught a cold, and I never tried it again.
Yeah. Let's get right to the story presented by our first team of challengers, all three of whom claim to be Patty Nowakowski. And here is her story. Please read along with me. I, Patty Nowakowski, am a surrogate mother who unexpectedly gave birth to twins, a boy and a girl. The couple who contracted for the baby only wanted one of the twins, the girl. The thought of separating them broke my heart. My husband and I felt that we wanted the twins to be raised together, and the other couple agreed, so we kept them both. We realized then that babies born out of surrogate agreements have no protection. I, who once approved of surrogate parenting, am now definitely opposed. I'm proud to say that as a result of my testimony in the state legislature, surrogate contracts are outlawed in my state. Signed, Patty Nowakowski. Welcome, mothers. We'll find out more about Patty Nowakowski right after this. Welcome back to Tell the Truth. All right, panel. These three people all claim to be Patty Nowakowski, a surrogate mother who had a change of heart. Let's start the questioning on this with Kitty Carlisle.
Thank you. Number two, what state was it that you had the laws changed?
Arkansas.
And number three, is there a standard fee for surrogate mothers?
Yes, $10,000.
That's standard all around the country?
It varies depending in each situation.
Ah, and number one, you didn't have that test that shows the not only whether you're going to have twins, but shows the sex of the child.
I did have a test. At 4 months, I had an ultrasound test.
And shows. You couldn't tell you were going to have twins?
Yes, I could tell. That's when I found that I was having twins.
Ah, and number two, why did you feel...
Sorry about that, Kitty. Tom.
You know, my mother gave birth to twins unexpectedly. My brothers, Tim and Terry, are twins. She didn't know. I just thought I'd tell you that.
Thank you.
Number one, was the boy or the girl born first?
The boy.
And if you had just had the boy or the girl, and it all went through smoothly, do you think you'd still feel the same way, number one, about surrogate parenting?
Wait, could you repeat that? I didn't quite.
Neither did I.
But you were cute doing it. If you had just had one, this whole process might not have come about because it might have worked smoothly. Is that true?
Well, the other couple had not indicated that they would not take a boy child.
I see.
Okay, Mary Ann.
Number two, did you have other children?
Yes, I did.
How many other children did you
have? Two.
Number three, what was the reason that you decided to go through with this?
I thought it'd be a wonderful thing to do for another couple. And I also thought that it'd be helpful to have the extra money.
Number one, what other states have legal protections for surrogate mothers or for children born of surrogate parentage?
Well, as far as I know, I'm from Ohio. Ohio, New Jersey, and Michigan are the only states that I'm aware of.
Number two, what you originally thought was a good thing about this presumably still is a good thing. Why have you changed your mind?
Because the children, there's really no laws protecting them. I mean, you know, it's like picking the pick of the litter.
Yeah, number three, how are they not protected any more than any other child who's up for adoption, say?
Oh, geez, in surrogacy, like number two said, there is no protection to the child, where in adoption, the decision is made after the child's born.
Number one, do you think that there's anything good about it? I mean, do you have mixed feelings about the new stand you've taken?
I used to have mixed feelings, but no, I have a very definitive stand now that I am against it, adamantly against it.
Number one again.
Well, time's up, I'm sorry, Orson, and it's time to vote for either number one, number two, or number three. Our team of challengers will each receive $500 for every incorrect vote, with a guarantee of $1,000. And if the panel is fooled completely, the team will receive $3,000. Panel, if you're ready to cast your votes, we'll begin with Kitty.
Well, number one was very good about being adamantly opposed and all of that and reeling off the states. And number three was very good, too, saying that it was not only a nice thing to do, but the money was important. And I think that's very realistic. But when number two said it was the pick of the litter, I could tell that she felt that was a terrible thing.
Okay, Tom.
This is, of all the people we've seen all these days we've been doing this, I think you could all be surrogate mothers, but gut feeling is that the phrase, the pick of the litter. I think number two as well, but everybody was completely convincing.
Mary Ann.
Well, I think it's an interesting problem. I can see your point of view, and then I see the point of view of those who try desperately and want to have children. I think you're all wonderful, and my feeling was that it was number two.
Clean sweep. Are you declaring yourself out of this vote?
We may be skunked on this, or we might...
Awesome. Oh.
Down to glory.
This is the first time this has ever happened in my recent memory, in my only short time on the show. Okay, no vote for number one, four for number two, none for number three. Let's find out who the real surrogate mother is. Will the real Patty Nowakowski please stand up?
Don't believe it.
Unbelievable. Now let's meet Patty's husband, Aaron. Come on in, Aaron. Well, you said you had three kids. You've now got five children. And you're so smiling. Tell me, are you going to tell your two children that what the circumstances were, the twins? Are you going to tell them or not?
Yes, we'll be honest.
Really?
And when they become of age, if they want to know, their biological father will tell them.
Okay, what's your feeling now with a family of five, unexpectedly large? Aaron?
It's a lot of fun.
Is it?
Really is.
You want more kids?
I don't think so.
Thanks very much for joining us on The Tell the Truth. Imposter number one, no votes. What's your real name? What do you do?
My name is Leslie Dunn. I'm a secretary for a residential psychiatric treatment center for children in Los Angeles.
Okay. And number two, great job. Poor Buzz, you fooled everybody.
Yeah. Well, my real name is Anita Taylor, and I'm a staff sergeant in the United States Air Force.
Well, you stumped the panel, so your team receives $3,000, and thank you very much, all of you, Aaron included, for being with us here today on Tell the Truth. We'll be back with the world's toughest cop right after this. Welcome back to Tell the Truth. Let's meet our next team of challengers.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Terry Lopez.
Number two.
My name is Terry Lopez.
Number three.
My name is Terry Lopez.
Okay, panel, time to locate the real Terry Lopez. And here is her story. Please read along with me. I, Terry Lopez, am the world's toughest cop. I'm a three-time winner of an athletic competition called the Toughest Cop Alive. Within 7 hours, I complete a 3-mile run, a shot put, a 100-yard sprint, a 100-yard swim, a 20-foot rope climb, the bench press, pull-ups, and finally a grueling obstacle course. When I first joined the department, they asked me to drop out. I was out of shape and couldn't keep up with the other recruits. Now I'm an officer in our tough anti-gang unit, and we work the city's most deadly neighborhoods. We're up against 77,000 known gang members. My most important goal is to be a positive role model and keep the children out of gangs. Signed, Terry Lopez. Welcome, officers. Let's start the questioning on this one with Orson Bean.
Hey, Terry, number one, you're tough, huh? You want to step outside?
Sure, you ready?
All right. Please be gentle with me. Number three, when you were in this competition, did you compete just against other females?
Yes.
Yeah. Number two, do any gang members ever hear about your reputation and try to give you a hard time just because you're so tough?
Actually, they have heard about my reputation, but instead of giving me a hard time, it actually works in my favor.
Yeah. Number one, have you made friends with any tough girls in the street that you think that you have maybe changed the direction they were going in?
I'd like to think so.
Yeah. Number three, how about you, Sam? All right.
Sorry about that, Mary Ann.
Number three, where does this competition take place?
All over the world.
When you joined number two, was there a height requirement or a weight requirement?
Yes. 5'1". There's not a weight requirement.
Number one, how many pounds can you bench press?
170.
That's a lot of cup. Tom. Hey.
Number one, how many push-ups can you do?
I can't even fan.
Push-ups?
Push-ups, yeah.
You can do about 50.
In one stretch, excuse me, one number one again, in one stretch?
You're talking about push-ups or pull-ups?
Push-ups.
About 50, yeah.
That's great. That's a lot of push-ups. Number two, how long did it take the transformation from you coming in and them saying you're out of shape to you being in this great shape? What time frame in your life?
The police academy is 6 months long, and when I joined during the third week, the sergeant told me that I should quit and give it up. But by the time I graduated, I had lost 28 pounds.
Number two again, what made you want to be a cop?
My ex-husband was a cop.
Oh. Ex? Stress on the ex. Kitty.
Number three, what's the most important thing, aside from being a role model, to keep kids out of gangs? What is the most important thing that you feel?
Your leadership abilities and also setting a prime example for the community.
Number two, is there anything else you can think of? I mean, should they have recreation? Should they have schooling? Should they have what else?
Yes, all those things. We work with the community to try to get those things going.
And number one, how old were you when you joined the force that you were so out of shape?
Well, I was 24.
And how much overweight were you?
I'm embarrassed to say right now. 25 pounds.
Number three, where in the neighborhood that you work in?
We've got to leave it there. I'm sorry, Kitty. Time's up. Time to vote for either number one, number two, or number three. Our team of challengers will receive $500 for each incorrect vote, with a guarantee of $1,000. And if the panel is fooled completely, the team will receive $3,000. Panel, are you ready to cast your ballots? If you are, Orson, could you begin?
Well, I'm tempted to vote for one because I'm afraid if I don't, you'll beat the hell out of me. But I'm going to take a hunch and vote for number two.
Okay. Mary Ann.
Well, I thought they were all very convincing. Number two was very articulate. Number one seemed very fit. But I think it's number three.
Okay. Interesting. Tom.
It's hard because number one is, I could see her on the street being tough and I'd be afraid. But number two has this posture. It looks like she's been through some sort of academy where they told her to sit up straight, which seems to me like...
Yeah, Sister Maria, she told me to sit up straight. That was an academy. Kitty.
Well, they're all wonderful. Number one has that wonderful kind of tough lingo. Number two really looks very athletic. When she came down the stairs, she walked very well. But somehow when number three told me the reasons, the things that would really influence young people, I believed her. So I voted for number three.
Okay, Kitty. There you can see the votes. None for number one, despite her tough posture. Number two, two votes. Number three, two votes. Okay, let's find out who the real tough cop is. Will the real Terry Lopez please stand up? Ah! Congratulations. Now, Terry, I actually did a story with you one day about 2 years ago. You took me into the gangs and we spent a day together, and I think you nearly saved my life by the afternoon. It's no mucking around out there. How dangerous is it today?
It's just as bad.
Is it getting better?
We like to think so. We like to think that we're winning the war.
marvelous example you've set for yourself and all, of course, all the people in your community. Let's find out who the imposters really are. Number one, no votes. What's your real name? What do you do?
Thanks. My name is Gwendolyn Mitchell, and I'm a securities broker with Brokers Investment West.
Yeah. You're not so tough, are you? Number two, two votes. What's your name? What do you really do?
My name is Chris Mowry, and I sell books at Walden Bookstore.
Well, there were two incorrect votes at $500 a vote, so your team will receive $1,000, and thank you all for being with us today on To Tell the Truth. And we've added something new on To Tell the Truth. It's called One-on-One, and we'll be back to play it with someone from our studio audience right after this. Welcome back to Tell the Truth. Now it's time to play One-on-One with someone from our studio audience. Burton, who do you have for us today?
Well, Gordon, I'd like you to meet Rita Atkins of Redondo Beach, California.
Welcome, Rita.
Thank you.
Okay, here's your chance to play One-on-One. I want you to now meet a gentleman with two stories, Matt Greenhouch. Welcome, Matt. Now, Rita, Matt is going to tell you two stories, only one of which is the truth. If you can spot the true story, you'll win $500. Matt, your first story.
I had the hiccups for 154 days and was cured by a hypnotist.
Okay, now that may or may not be the truth, Rita. Let's listen to Matt's second story. You can't believe it. Okay.
I became famous for wearing smelly shoes. I won the 1990 Rotten Sneaker Contest.
Okay. All right. Now, Rita, panel's going to help you here win that $500. Each of the panel will ask one question about both of those stories. Let's start with story number one, the hiccups and Kitty.
Mr. Greenhouse, how much weight did you lose in those 154 days?
Not much, maybe 3 pounds, not really.
Tom.
Matt, before you went to the hypnotist, I'm sure there were a lot of people offering a million different cures. Try this, try this. What was the weirdest one they said to do?
Well, one of my friends told me to stand on my head and breathe heavily.
Marianne.
Matt, do you happen to know the record for the longest days of having hiccups?
Yes, I was told it was 3 years.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, there was a famous pope had the hiccups for even longer than you. Do you happen to know who that was?
No.
Name any pope, no one knows.
Okay, Rudy, you've heard Matt's first story and some of the ridiculous questions. Now story number two, rotten sneakers. And Kitty.
Who voted for you in this disgusting contest?
Well, it wasn't a voting kind of thing. It was more a panel of judges.
It was a smelling kind of thing. Tom.
How do these shoes get so smelly? Does it have to some special process, or does it have to do with your feet?
It's not having to do with my feet, I can tell you.
He's just a gifted child, Tom. Marianne.
Hello, no, wait.
Okay.
I'm afraid to ask it. How long did you wear these sneakers?
6 months.
You see, he's gifted. Awesome.
I'd like to defer and offer Kitty a chance to ask yet another question. Who picked the judges for this, and how close were they able to get to the winning sneaker?
I'm not sure who picked the judges.
All right. Wasn't a great question, was it?
Okay, now, Rudy, you've heard the cross-examination. Did Matt, in your opinion, have hiccups for 154 days, or did he win the rotten sneaker contest?
Well, I think he won the rotten sneaker contest because I think he'd lose more weight if you had the hiccups that long, okay, because you can't eat.
Okay, well, if you're right, you win $500. Matt, what is your true story?
To tell the truth, I won the rotten sneaker contest.
And thanks for playing One-on-One.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good on you. And, panel, yes, you guessed it. I have it here. I've got the sneaker from the Hall of Fumes. Perhaps you'd like 6 months? You did this in 6 months? What, you got acid coming out of your pores? Now, I'll get these. Here's one for you, Tom, and a little bit of salad with that, sir. We could. Okay, thank you very much. All righty.
Well, it's got a life of its own, doesn't it?
It does. It can walk home without anything in it. We'll be back with more right after these short words. Welcome back. Well, panel, that's it for this edition of To Tell the Truth. Memorable moments. I know you'll share with us the smell of those sneakers forever, won't you? I'll never get around once again. Thanks very much. You were a lot of fun.
Thank you.
Okay. We'll see you all next time. Cheerio, nurse.
How far would you go to win Olympic gold?
Nothing would stop Tonya Harding. Nothing.
How far to win an election?
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
How far to win the trial of the century?
If it doesn't fit, you must acquit.
Anything to Win, the new documentary series about people who refuse to lose. January 10th, it's Rosie Ruiz and the Boston Marathon scandal.
Nobody in the world could have run that fast.
Anything to Win, premieres Tuesday, January 10th at 9, only on GSN.
I remember the first time I saw Chuck. It was a Monday.
Did you know Chuck's a Pisces? I'm a Pisces, too.
I know everything about Chuck Woolery. Everything.
Flingo. It's not just a word game, it's an obsession. Tonight at 7 on GSN.